it's time to do some updates from Sweden. We are now approximately 10 days from the Varadero International Meeting held in Gotland this year. And the summer is really well going on here in Sweden. I think at the moment we have about 20 degrees of the warm and the sun is setting. It's around 8 o'clock in this moment. But first of that, I want to show you something that's happening in my garden. That's really fun to see. So I will see here, you can see what it is. I'll put it up in the tree. It's my apple tree in the garden here. And here they are. Quite fun. I hope they are still there. I don't know. I can't see much now, but pretty brilliant what I'm seeing. Yes, I was thinking about taking a ride in the evening here and just enjoy it, and I will talk about everything I have done and what you've been doing, and what we can expect from the meeting in Gotland. So, since then, bye-bye. Okay, I'm back with the block, just out riding. Took some moment to get dressed and have an evening spin. It hasn't been so much kilometers on over this year. Spring was very late and it has been cold, but now the summer is here. I got the temperature about 70 degrees now. Sun is setting. And it's really beautiful. I just love this time of the year in Sweden. And from now on we have got approximately 1 month left to the midsummer. So this is Sweden, folks. And just look at the trees, look at the green everything had been just recently. 2 weeks ago it was nothing. Everything has just exploded on the trees here. So yeah, I'm out of a little spin and continue this vlogging. First time I'm really trying to speak English when I'm riding, because I have so much international friends now that it's better to speak in a national language that more can understand than just using Swedish all the time. Of course it's easier for me to speak Swedish, but well, if there is some word I don't just can get and explain, well, you have to live with it. Perhaps I'm using the wrong word, but whatever. I think you will understand the most part of what I'm saying anyway. So, I got a new camera. It's a Garmin Virb, and it's connected via Bluetooth to my headset in the helmet. So therefore, I can speak with you right now without any cables. It is also connected to the phone, so you can see what I'm filming, and yeah, so it's a lot. I thought it was cheap. It's a really good camera, and nothing extra but a cable to get power when I'm riding, so I don't get flat of battery, but that's it. So now I'm a little outside the country, not far from my home, but this is what it looked like. This will turn out to the gravel road in a short time. And just, yes, I'm taking it's an amazing evening, so I just want to get out and take a spin for like 45 minutes or something and just get it on, look at the waters and everything. Here they are in this sea that we're passing now. They have some canoe renting and lots of activities during the summer. It's real nice here. The sun is setting from behind, and how light is it still? It's about half past 8. 8:30, that's better to say. 8:30 in the afternoon, or evening, what do you prefer? So, I'm just well, it's only 10 days left for the Varadero International Meeting. And we'll meet you guys again from the Honda Adventure Riders Forum. It's been 1 year since last time, and I hope since Sweden now we're arranging this event, I hope it will be great and that I have some good weather, and that you will find Sweden amusing, and that we can have a real laid-back meeting and just enjoy and everything. And also, when I have to do it quite early in time now, I have to do some points of interest for you that I put out. I got the points, but I need to do a rule book so you know what it is that you're driving for. So it's coming on, and I will upload it to the vim19.com site. There you will find the download section and just download it. And it is accessible for both Garmin and TomTom satnavs. So that will be, well, I hope it will be some easier. But then you can take your own excursion. We don't need to be around 40 bikes in a long row. You do like in Winterberg, taking all what's pleasant, and maybe ride three, four bikes in a gang and see what's happening. And then we will explore and discover any more beyond those waypoints. It's just setting goals. The island isn't that big. It's about 300 kilometers in length, but it's enough, and it's a lot of explore, and it's also a busy weekend. Many Stockholmers just want to go to Gotland because it's not so nice, so it's going to be a lot of tourists. We also have a wedding at our site that we are living, so there's going to be a lot of party groups in the same time. So we will hope that everything will match and everything will work fine, and also with the boats. And also I will put out my telephone number if you have any problems, see if I can fix it. And if I have any friends in the neighborhood, they can help you with the tools or garage or whatever. So I will put that out. Also, I will put it out in a video that's coming along to this. And WhatsApp, it's a great app to use international contacting. It's very handy. You don't need so much more than a network around you, and it not cost you on the phone bill or whatever. So it's quite a good app. Everybody don't have Facebook, so I will try to just get it on. Here the gravel road starting, and the end of the asphalt. And I haven't been on this road for a year now or two, I don't know. I'm a little bit unfamiliar. Also, I got a brand new rear tire, so I have to rub it in. So it can be a little slippery, I don't know. But we'll try it, see what's happening. See, the gravel roads here are like in the asphalt, because there's no gravel on them, it's just mud, some had dried. But, we have it's dried out. When this is wet, it can be real slippery, it can be more slippery than ice. So I just love to ride in this little road. At this end, we're going to ride out and we're going to head up for a campsite, so not to use an abandoned place. So this is just around my corner, and that's terrific about Sweden, that you have the nature so close on you, and not very trafficked or whatever. So people just live there or have some kind of summer residence or whatever. I don't know how much the camera will show you. I have another view from when I can point my head. See, I can change the angle of the camera and coming back to you. So this is it. Of course, I can ride faster, but I'm not used to it. So I'm just taking it calm and speaking while I'm riding. So it's just fun, and I thought like, well, it's a nice evening, and I don't want to go to bed yet, so just running around here and get a look at things. So we are 39 people coming to the event, and it's going to be really nice to meet you again. And some of you haven't seen for like 4 or 5 years. Some of you never shown up before, so this would be the first time. David coming from New Zealand, Jack is on his way from Israel, and the bike's just shipping on the boat right moment in the moment. And that's it. And then the bigger Dave will arrive in Sweden next Sunday, so he's a little bit ahead, but he will. He just started to think he will go to Geiranger with the Varadero. He will have tried it before, but just in a parachute, a car. So they want to ride that, and then coming to Gotland when the meeting starts in Friday evening. What's happening more? Yeah, well, I have to think about it, and I'm coming back to you later on, I think. It'll be fun to be a little quiet also. My voice is, oh, hello, asphalt here. Right. Last time I ride here was gravel, but I asphalt it. Yeah, it's really nice, just people living in the countryside here, and their horse farms mostly. People are really interested in horses in this side of the town I'm living in. And it's a perfect area for it. Just going out in nature and, yes. Also very fun to ride bikes, but not in the woods, because we are doing huge impact on the forest, and it's just getting dirty and muddy. People want to get bored. Also in autumn here, the rate of the mushrooms. So you can go out and pick whatever you want, all the wild berries, like blueberry, and also the famous, not so much here in the south, but, what's the name of that? Oh, the Laponian wild berry. Well, it's really nice taste of it. Just mix it with some vanilla and some sugar, and you have a great jelly. There's a little bit of gravel on the tarmac here, so I'm very cautious. You never know what's happening, but it's still quite a good, amazing night. Evening, just being coming out, and that's what I love about this country. Summertime and the late evenings like this, going out at 9 in the evening, and it's like day outside. A perfect day. It's been really warm, 25 degrees. I couldn't hardly sit on the sun. So a little bit of windy conditions, not that temperature yet in the air. It's blowing kind of hard from the sea, but it's getting warmer all the time, and I think Gotland will really showing something. Let's just hope it's not raining. Oh, it's cat. Never been to Gotland by myself before. There's only a countryside I've never been to. In Sweden we have 24 counties, if you say like that. And I have been in every one of them and slept in there, all from the south to the north, except for Gotland. It's a little bit tricky to get from the west coast to the island of Gotland, so therefore it's just a lot of planning to go there, and boats are always a problem. Just look at this. I have to show you the camera later here. The water is like a mirror. it's so amazing nice. See, I can find a zone. If I can have a gap between the trees here, see. And can I show this? And so just viewing the sun setting in the water, quite nice. Yeah, we might have something. Just turning around. See again. Ooh, do something. How is it reacting? No. You see it? Look great. Not the best spot I picked, but anyway. What's wrong here? There's a lot of horses. Well, see like this, have a tennis court and two Porsches. Yeah, yeah. Some people had a good in Sweden as well. And here we're now arriving to that campsite and bath place I was talking about. It's not that frequently visited, and it's a good thing about Sweden, but there's a lot of this area, it's not so crowded, and I really enjoy it. See if I can find a spot here to see if we can see it. There's something, someone running. Can be fun to see. Down the flow. Need flow. Look at this. It's excellent. Just look at it. And here you can lie on the vacation, not so crowded, and just take a bath in the sea. It's perfect. The most of all, in our country, on the west coast, we like the salty water, so, and the breeze from the ocean. But this is a lake, and there are lots of them, but it's more in Finland, and a lot of people of you think you are heading to Finland after or coming from Finland after, before the meeting, so there's a lot of plans to have a real road trip. And also I invited Honda to the meeting and see where we're getting. That's KTM rider, I think I know him. So we will see what's happening. There's a lot of things that's happening here. I'm very sorry for the late update about when the meeting and the booking system and everything, but this autumn was terrible for me, so I really lacked out. It was a lack of energy, and I didn't feel so good. So, but when the sun started to rise again getting up in the morning, it was easier. Now I'm full of energy, and I really like this period of the year, and it's going to be so good to meet you all guys again. You're all so amazing, friendly, and it's a good gang that always come together, and everybody is so polite, and we can do whatever you want. Well, there is some language barrier, but not too much. We can understand each other, and also our English will improve. It's a problem with the French speakers. I don't know if we have an interpreter this year for the French, but hopefully we will do something. Oh, I've got the heating on the Oxford heaters on the handlebar. It's getting a little warm. I just wonder why. That's because of my my little tank bag here. So which right, I think I will go left. All right, there's some gravel in the corner here. Yeah, so now I will show you about Sweden and how I'm living. So I have been recording now for 18 minutes, so I think it's we're going to be a real good 20 minutes will be enough, and I would say bye for now and come back with other information soon. Have a good one. Bye.